Oh, Jamer's here. Hello, Jamer. Good to have ya. Good to have ye. Good to have ye here.
Whoa. I was gone.
Of course you missed me. I was gone last week.
You didn't get to see me last week.
You did just barely miss me at the pickle party. I must have just left. Yeah, I don't know. You didn't tell me you would be there. Whoa.
I could have seen you.
But you didn't tell me. Tell me you were going to be there. Oh. There was a pickle party in Portland, Oregon. It was fun. There was a pickle eating contest. I watched it. I saw it with mine own two eyes.
I had fun at the pickle party.
The pickles were good.
Hi there. You know Fred Flintstone in the commercials when he's like, "Hi there." You know what I'm talking about? You probably don't know what I'm talking about. You probably never heard of that. You probably never heard of Fred Flintstone, huh? Oh, it's a pickle joke? Give me a pickle joke! Joke! He goes, "Yagabadoo!" Yeah. Hi there! He does that too. Which is fun. You call poops brown pickles. I think you're gonna fit in just fine around here, Jamer. I think you're gonna fit in just fine.
This day of your time, how are you?
I think we're gonna have a fine time together, Jamer. What do you say we rip in, huh?
Welcome
to my show! I give you a like finger. That's a thumbs up, baby. Heard of it? Have you heard of a thumbs up? You heard of a like finger? Welcome to Hold Space for My Tribe. We're going to watch some YouTubes tonight.
Tonight.
I want to do it tonight.
I want them on the grill.
I want my YouTube videos on the grill. The garlic scapes pickling in my fridge should be ready to eat tomorrow. I repeat, the garlic scapes pickling in my fridge should be ready to eat tomorrow. The garlic scapes pickling in my fridge should be ready to eat tomorrow. The garlic scapes pickling in the house!
Everybody just
have a good time! Oh, give me the beat, boys, and free my soul. I want to get lost in your rock and roll. Do I ever get pickled? I've been pickled a time or two. Usually after I cease to be, once I die and some sort of ill-advised scheme or a self-imposed explosion, my remains are generally preserved by those who miss me. And this can be in a brine, this could be in a fermentation process, this could be in bandages and salt. I become mummified remains for you until I am resurrected, usually by some kind of chunk of my body. What the fuck is up? What the fuck's up? You may remember last week we watched this guy, Divine Being Divine, and he put up some videos about drinking piss. Let me jog your memory. And he's deleted these piss videos, which so fucking disappointing. But we can watch what's left. He still talks about piss a lot. It's this guy. We talked about him in the patron stream a little bit more. He's really into drinking piss. Like, he loves it.
This is 5D Earth, we divine beings, and I'm a light being, y'all, so I'm striking. Every time I speak, y'all, it's igniting. I'm electric, so I'm like lightning.
Yeah.
Lightning, open up my pee. Every time I drink urine bolts into my being, and I light weed.
Yeah.
So I'm high heaved up, energies arising.
Every time I drink pee, bolts into my being. You heard the man. It's not that complicated. I drink pee, bolts into my being. Any questions? Hey! Any questions for me? But I got one where he does talk about drinking piss.
The human body is so intelligently designed that we actually have our own internal vaccination system.
Now, keep in mind, he's an anti-vaxxer. Now, what do you think the chances are of being... Imagine a Venn diagram between anti-vaxxers and piss drinkers, okay? These circles are close if it's not just one circle altogether. I mean, these are, if you don't believe in vaccines, you might believe in piss drinking for health.
All of the minerals that people are deficient in can be found in fruits and vegetables all around the world.
Yeah.
I understand that many people have allergies to a lot of foods. Therefore, this video is for all the people who have any allergies in general. The information I'm about to share with you is extremely important and should have been your birthright knowledge. The medical industry is the biggest moneymaker in the world, and that is because your health is a business. There's only one disease, which is mucus. Therefore, all medicine is a hoax.
Did you hear that? There's only one disease, which is mucus. All right.
Are being played. All doctors do is prescribe to you a temporary treatment, which causes more harm than good. They can never actually cure anything. Only herbs can, and also your urine, which is what.
Only herbs. Only herbs. Only herbs may cure my illness. Herbs and urine, of course. Herbs and, yes, of course, my urine. This is the new Zelda. This is piss of a kingdom.
Can, and also your urine, which is what I want to talk to you about today.
Yeah, I want to talk to you about piss. Let's read some of this. Aries, I am infant potassium phosphate Brazil nuts now. You know, I love bullshit. You might have noticed this about me. If you watch my internet show, you might know that I love bullshit. And let me tell you, I love a chart that's labeled astrochemical chromatic chart. Okay? This is what I love. Taurus, I have baby sodium sulfate kale. All right? And that's future. Not yet. I don't have it yet. Okay? So this is fun. This is astrology. This is salad. This is time. This is color. I love it. Gemini. I think child potassium chloride apples.
And words, man. We made them up.
In the past. Okay. This is good stuff. I don't think... So if someone could write something this complicated, I think they must know a thing or two about drinking piss. So I think drinking piss... I mean, if I take this guy's word for it, is good. I don't think that. Don't drink your piss. Don't pay attention to any of this. I mean, listen, if you're a Taurus, should you eat kale? Maybe. Should you drink your piss? No. No, don't do it. What are you talking about? All right. I mean, you can. You can eat kale, probably, unless you got an allergy to it. But that's who this video is for. It's for people with allergies, right? Cancer. I feel adolescent calcium fluoride mushrooms. Now, Leo, I will teenager magnesium phosphate cherries in the future. Virgo, I analyze adult potassium sulfate onions in the past. Libra, I balance marriage sodium phosphate tomatoes. Scorpio, I desire sex calcium sulfate cucumbers. Now, God damn it, why the Scorpios always gotta, we always gotta be the sex one? Well, light it up!
No! I'm tired of you! Light it!
Of course, the Scorpio gets the cucumber. What's calcium sulfate? Is that a horny thing too? I appreciate all the Scorpios. We get bad press, and we press bad. Okay, when there's two buttons before me, one's good, one's bad. I press bad. I press the bad boy button every day. Scorpio fucks. I'm a goddamn cucumber, baby. I tell you what.
I tell you what.
Somebody look up calcium sulfate for me and tell me how it may be applied to my beehole for sex.
Now, before I get into any detail about that, it's critical to understand that when a snake injects you with its venom, you must be able to describe exactly which snake has bitten you so that you can be given the correct antivenom. If you don't know what bit you, you will indeed have a slow and painful reaction, which would be very unfortunate. However, this can be avoided.
Oh.
I'm going to explain a few more details before we get to the main thesis. Your tonsils are actually lymph nodes located in the back of the mouth and at the top of the throat. You also have lymph nodes underneath your armpits, which is why you should make your own deodorant and stop.
Oh, what's up, Pop-Tart? Regards to you.
It gets absorbed by these lymph nodes, and it will weaken your immune system. And you also have lymph nodes all throughout your abdomen. I personally am not allergic to anything, but there is a video on YouTube called Andrew Norton Weber's Allergy Testimonial with Urine Therapy.
Here we go.
That's the main subject matter. If you get bitten by a snake or a spider, or stung by a scorpion or a bee, or even swallow peanut butter or walnuts by accident,
this
is how you prevent any allergic reaction whatsoever.
Drink piss.
Now, when any pathogen or poison enters the bloodstream, it only takes about 10 to 15 seconds for your kidneys to filter that blood, which ultimately ends up getting expelled through your urine, which is why the medical term for urine is plasma ultrafiltrate. Inside the filtered blood sample called urine, there will be nanoparticulates called antigens, which is a very small piece of the pathogen. It is such a small fraction of the poison, it is not enough to actually harm you, but it is enough for your body to analyze it and create a vaccine or a solution to the very issue at hand. All you have to
do is
place a bit of the urine that is contaminated underneath your tongue just long enough for the lymph nodes to study the antigen, which will then communicate to the immune system.
This isn't true.
The antibodies that will eliminate the pathogen that is in the rest of the bloodstream. You can keep your EpiPen on standby just for precautionary reasons, but it's guaranteed that you will not have any reaction at all. Just allow your body to relax at an upright.
Who's that guy? Andrew Norton Weber's Allergy Testimonial with Urine Therapy. That's what my band is called. Andrew Norton Weber's Allergy Testimonial on Urine Therapy. We're going to look this up. Andrew Norton Weber, urine. Health secrets revealed by urine. I think we're going to have to watch that. Here we go. This is on Baltimore Local News is what this is, and we're going to talk about drinking piss. Hey, thank you!
Thank you!
Andrew Dice Clay on drinking piss.
Mr. Stanley Silver joins us now with more information. Nice to see you.
Thank you.
You know, we were being silly before, but what this presents to us is a kind of window into our health on a daily basis, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
We get a lot of calls constantly by people looking at the urine, seeing abnormalities, and are concerned. A lot of different colors.
This is not the guy.
Can mean some problems.
Okay, so
this is Stanley Silber.
The number one thing we should look for is essentially the color, correct?
Correct.
Okay, so
Stanley Silber, the urine filter.
Clear would be the optimum, or what is the optimum?
I think clear is the optimum. I think clear is usually a well-hydrated persons who the urine is usually amber or almost a lemonade color, light color.
Okay, and at what point should
just talking piss
be alerted?
I think if the there are marked changes in the color of the urine, certainly a brownish urine could possibly indicate some liver problems. A red urine, which is our worst alarm, is could certainly indicate a problem with.
I'm a piss guy. They bring me on the news to talk about piss.
A tumor somewhere in the urinary system.
And that is key, of course, because correct. Bladder cancer is a very deadly.
I don't think this guy drinks piss. Andrew Norton Weber, urine. I don't see this coming up. I think maybe the Illuminati took this one down. Andrew Norton Weber appears to be him. And distillers, okay. I don't know. I don't know if we're going to find this piss guy. This piss clown could be a... Well, let's watch this video from 11 years ago called Urine Distilling 002. I'm ready to take some risks.
Warm liquid by distilling it. Tonight, I will be making drinking water out of my own urine.
Yeah.
Okay, so the items that we will need for this experiment is, first off, you'll need something to hold.
Listen, is it Tuesday, or am I just watching a man in a Got Wood t-shirt distill his own urine? Or is it Tuesday, when I do that every week?
Urine in. I will be using something like this to hold my urine in. Next step, you'll need.
There it is, it's the piss guy.
You pour the urine into the pot and boil any of the impurities or bacteria out of the urine, just to be safe.
Hey man, I'm trying to make a piss drinking video. You mind not walking through my shot?
Impurities or bacteria out of the urine.
Christ, and pay your fucking rent.
Next, I have this is the distilling process. I have my great grandmother's antique teapot that I asked to borrow.
And it's chock full of my piss. I'm sorry, great granny. I pissed in your teapot. Oh, I filled it up with my foamy yellow. Let me tell you.
You make some special tea. And so don't tell grandma. And
don't tell grandma I turned her prized teapot into a piss distillery. Pistillery. In high school, a guy named Donnie McComb pissed in a spray bottle and sprayed it in my mouth. Ew. Gross. We're moonshining piss. I got a piss still. Yeah, I'm running piss. The federales are hot on my trail, but I got grandma's tea kettle full of my piss. That's what I got.
This tube.
It's a piss pot.
We're going to heat up the water, and it will catch the water. And
someone's at the door.
It goes into the cup. It will condense and...
Put away your piss steamer. Okay, stop condensing your piss in the kitchen, Bradley. Bradley?
Bradley, stop condensing your piss in the kitchen.
But I want to. I just want to drink it. I want to make drinking water out of my piss.
Bradley, you pour your piss down the sink and you got your room.
But I just want to drink some water.
We have water.
No, but this is water I already drank, but I want to drink it again. I'm recycling.
Bradley, you go to your room and you drink your piss raw. You drink your piss raw like a normal boy. You drink your piss like a normal boy with the wood shirt.
I don't even want to wear this shirt.
I'll make you wear that shirt. I told you, you need to. Anytime you're in my kitchen, you wear a shirt that says Got Wood. You wear a shirt that says Got Wood to remind you of your lumberjack ancestry.
But I just want to drink my piss. I don't want to be a lumberjack's kid. They need urine family therapy. They need to drink each other's piss until they can get along as a family unit. My stepson and I fell asleep watching Hell's Kitchen. We woke up in a clandestine piss distillery wearing only Got Wood shirts.
A lot of piss through my nose.
I've never smelled such a smell in my life. I don't want to be Lumberjack's kid. I just want to drink distilled piss.
Make water. This cap or this thing that we're using here just accelerates the process. So these
Big Johnson shirt.
Items that you can find around the house, pretty common. And so now we'll start the experiment. So right now I'm harvesting the urine that we'll be using for the experiment. So yeah.
What do you think this guy's up to now? This is 11 years ago. Where's he working? Who's his boss? Did he ever find wood? Did he ever find wood? Or nay? Bug Long Johnson. Hi, I'm Bug Long Johnson, and I want to drink my own piss. And I want to let everyone watch me do it. Wow, he's pissing a lot. He works at a T-Mobile call center and believes in QAnon. You saw him at Jamba Juice. Oh, that, I'm just glad he's working. I'm glad he's got somewhere to go.
Got our urine. Let's go. Okay, so now that we have our urine, the next step is to boil it and to get out any the impurities, bacteria, anything that may make me sick. So
boil your piss, Bradley. His YouTube name is Gil Givens 1. And he has 3 subscribers. Now, this is Urine Distilling 002. Is it possible that this is a sequel? Or dare I say a squeakquel? They're turning the piss gay. This guy is either making a ton of money or he's like working food service at a mall. I couldn't tell you, but I mean, his true passion is, of course, distilling urine. Pequel, thank you. Thank you very much for that. Happiest you've ever been.
Just pour this in here. And turn
where did that other guy come from?
And turn on the stove.
My brother's just right, boiling his piss.
Boil for a little while, so come back later and we'll... Okay, so it's been... My pee has been boiling for a little while.
Take two. Take two. The first take was no good.
5 minutes now. And we let it kind of...
Montifica, I hope you're feeling better. I hope this teenager fucking boiling his own piss makes you feel better. It's making me feel pretty good.
You don't want it to bubble over. Like, as you can see, we kind of let it bubble over.
Oh my god!
It really stinks, and my mom's gonna kill me because there's pee all over the stove. lesson learned. But anyway.
That's the grossest thing I've ever seen.
Step is to take the pee and transfer it into the tea kettle.
Grandma's tea kettle. That was the grossest thing I've ever seen.
You don't really want to boil it because you don't want it to bubble. You just want to get it hot enough so that it steams up and it can travel in here. But you don't want it to boil. So I'm going to do that right now.
Oh my god. I think this kid's like 16.
Okay. So now that the pee is in the tea kettle, we're going to turn this one on.
Sleep like a baby, boil your piss like a teenager, boil your cum like a man. I bet he feels like a real fool now that everyone's just drinking their piss raw. You know, he doesn't have to do any of this work. He could have cut this process in half. Just piss into your own mouth. Just stand, lean back, piss into your own mouth. That's called bubbling. And teenagers have been doing it since 2014.
And right there. So now we will just let it steam up and we'll put the camera over here and let it make water. So, okay, so it's been a few minutes since we started steaming the urine. And as you can see, there's some bubbles starting to form in here.
This boy's got a faux hawk and he's drinking his own piss.
And pretty soon it'll start to run.
Come up your own spine, yeah.
Condense in the cup, and we'll start getting some water to add up. And then,
Gil Givens, so, where are you now?
Stay tuned. So it hasn't been long, and we're already starting.
Hey, Paul will drink his own piss for 2 weeks if we get 25 subs. So just unsubscribe and subscribe again so that he can drink as much piss as he wants.
To drop into the cup. As I said before, we are getting some water to condense from this, from the, and it also we're, this lid is, helping it accelerate because we got some steam going up in there and then cooling down. And
he's just breathing in his own piss right now. This boy is huffing piss.
And in a few minutes, we'll have enough to be able to drink. All right, so we've been boiling for about 10 minutes here, and as you can see, we've got quite a bit of water in here. So I'm gonna go ahead and stop the distilling process.
Pickle party piss drinker.
Speed up this distilling process is having some more tube and running it through some ice. That would speed up the process by cooling
more tube
faster, and it'll condense faster. It'll get the water faster.
I need more tube
for the sake of this.
Now I have to go live with Dad.
So I'm going to go ahead and let this water cool off, and then I'll drink my urine. Ready?
The nebulizer was worse. Last week in the patron stream, we watched a guy put his own piss in a nebulizer and huff it. Or did we watch him do it, or he just talked about it? I don't know. He claims that it's saving his life because there's black mold in his van where he lives. So this these piss freaks are all over the charts.
All right, so it's been about 15 minutes. Everything's completely cooled off. Looking in here at the pee, you can tell it's a little more concentrated. You can tell that some of the water has escaped, and obviously it has. So now it's time for the moment you've all been waiting for. I'm going to drink my own urine. you can definitely smell the pee. It's in there. I mean, it's clear, but I can smell it. So I don't really know what to expect, but here we go.
Here we go.
Okay. It actually didn't taste that bad. It tastes like water with a little hint of something special, a little special ingredient.
The dad is filming. This looks like... kind of looks like a dad filming. I don't know. I don't know. You be the judge. A little something special.
We all know what that is, but it tasted all right. It was good. So
hey, it's your boy Night God. Thanks for subscribing to
Hold Space for My Tribe. Sorry, I didn't mean to cut that off. Thank you, Techno Sufi. Thank you so much. This guy's a hovercraft pilot now. This guy's been piloting drones from Las Vegas for years. For years.
Showed you guys how to distill your own water. I drank my own pee. So if you guys, go for it. If you don't want to take my word for it, it's so far we know it's safe. I don't know if I'm going to be sick, but go ahead and try it yourself. Go drink your own pee. And that's pretty much it.
I love YouTube from 11 years ago. It's the best. Yeah. The real star of the video is more hockey. That's good. That's a... Wow. What a fantastic video, if I do say so myself. Please applaud my curation for you. Please applaud me. Please tell me you love me. Wow, I don't know how we're going to top Gil Givens, but I got a lot more for you today. Thank you, Hambono. I love you, too. Let's watch some Rion. He's got some inflammatory things to say, as always. So let's.
Ladies and gentlemen, give him a chance. I cast it. I cast this in a brand new silicone mold, and I will be making these. So this is the Ganesh. It's coming in hot.
Look at that.
Put this over here next to little Buddha. Oi! These things are heavy.
He cast his own Ganesh.
All right, we're just going to... Here, I'll move you.
Thank you. Thank you for all of the praise that I requested. Thank you so much.
How much you...
I adore you.
There we go.
Thank you.
A lot of light coming in. Listen. But I made the Ganesh mold for you. My brother Eric crushed it. I don't know. I think I'll be making them solid blue azurite. I'll do solid colors for right now. I'm not going to get too crazy because I want to keep the price for you guys right in the best area we can.
How much do you think he's selling them for? Teamlightstore.com. How much do you think? I think $500. Pyramids, Third Eye, EMF Shielding, Dreamtime. How much do you think? 190? It's possible. Are they not up yet? This asshole. Wow. He sells some fucking wild shit. I don't think I've ever looked at this. What's on the sale rack? His Lightmare shirt. Nice. $35. All right, this is $199. It's an Angelic Azurite bed set. It's a Third Eye accelerator. Yeah, it has an LED light powered with minor lighting issues, including partial light outage on some colors or a mix of colors. It's 24 karat gold capped and especially highlights the vibrations of Aqua Aura and Angel Cards. When these two crystal frequencies are combined, they create the angelic shield. These pyramids are light encoded and one of a kind programmed to serve only their user. So that doesn't fucking mean anything to me. This is bullshit. This is just shit.
But I think I'll do a blue azurite.
Yeah,
a blue one. I don't know. Maybe I'll do a fire red protection one. But
he's Scottish. Did you know?
Okay. If you guys want to look up the patent for 1972, I believe there is an underground laser boring system that can drill underground a mile a day. The entire underneath the surface of this entire planet, and Musk can pretend to be a man for DARPA all he wants. They've had those cobalt drilling machines for 50 years. I'm sorry. I don't know who's writing your history books. It's absolutely ridiculous. Keep an eye on Antarctica. There's some new information coming out from some certain gentlemen that's talking about how these things can read not only all of the frequencies going into the Earth, but interplanetary, can track every single vessel coming in and out of this space based upon frequency. Okay, just pay attention to how advanced the things are behind the scenes that they're not telling the civilian population. It's one to be...
Certain gentlemen have been telling me about Antarctic frequency analyzers.
On that, we're not sleeping. Next. Okay. So I just want to be real and to all those people out there with common sense, fight for your common sense, ladies and gentlemen. We're not going to some weird dystopian situation. Rather, all these guys need to be arrested and thrown somewhere where there's no key.
That's
moving on. Okay.
Thrown somewhere where there's no key. When I was a kid, all my friends would make fun of me because I was the only one with a measly angelic azurite step pyramid while they had new Super 7 8-sided Nubian capstones. Oh, sound alerts might be offline. Hold on. Oh, they're back on. We might get blasted now with a bunch of them, though. Sorry. That must have been from when I was on a call or something. They're a little loud. Well, this guy's quiet, I think. I gotta get
How do you really feel when you wake up in the morning? I'm like, ooh, happy Father's Day. Be a real father. You've forgotten the face of your father.
All right. Don't be all weak sauce, okay? I don't know who I am. I'm like, try this out. Be independent. Don't be scared. Step into your power. For all you warrior women out there, love you too. All right.
The fuck is this guy talking about?
Yeah, so yeah, the whole smoke in New York City. Oh my God, it's like, you guys, it's a hologram. I'm not saying the fires aren't real. I'm not saying you're really breathing smoke. But what I'm trying to say is, what are they trying to create to put you in a frequency of, oh my goodness?
Blow my fucking wig back, baby. I want to hear that again.
Step into your power. From
this prison. My audio levels are out of whack, so the drops are real loud. Chopo, Jamer and his boyfriend broke up. No more boyfriend. I'm sorry, Jamer. Unless you didn't want to have a boyfriend, then congratulations. As at a pre-wedding banquet where a new age woman told a guy from Poland that there was no war in Ukraine, he suitably screamed at her. Yeah.
Woman out there, love you too. All right. Yeah, so yeah, the whole smoke in New York City. Oh my God, it's like, you guys, it's a hologram. I'm not saying the fires aren't real. I'm not saying you're really breathing smoke. But what I'm trying to say is, what are they trying to create to put you in a frequency of, oh my goodness? We all know where these jackasses' headquarters is. We all know, where is it?
Isn't it? Hell yeah, we still got Auto Clam. You're rocking with the best.
What happens if we take 200,000 light warriors and go, hey, I'm going to Satan Tofu's throne. I hope you guys are armed. Moving on. I don't know. These days are coming. I'm just trying to say, can someone go for the head of the snake? I'm so bored with all of these. You know?
This is fucking wild. We have never seen Rion so unhinged. What is happening? He hasn't made sense for over a minute. Let's go back. I want the full experience.
Okay. We all know where these jackasses have. All right. Don't be all weak sauce, okay? I don't know who I am. I'm like, try this out. Be independent. Don't be scared. Step into your power. For all you warrior women out there, love you too. All right. Yeah, so yeah, the whole smoke in New York City. Oh my God. It's a hologram. I'm not saying the fires aren't real. I'm not saying you're really breathing smoke. But what I'm trying to say is, what are they trying to create to put you in a frequency of,
oh my goodness.
Okay. We all know where these jackasses' headquarters is. We all know, I think it's in Switzerland somewhere, isn't it?
Hey, it's your boy Night God. Thanks for subscribing to Hold Space for My Tribe. Peace.
Peace. Peace. Thank you.
I don't know. I mean, what happens if we take 200,000 light warriors and go, hey, I'm going to Satan Tofu's throne. I hope you guys are armed. Moving on. I don't know. These days are coming. I'm just trying to say, can someone go for that?
I know. I left you on the Chopo cam. Sorry, I'm distracted. This is so funny to me.
Jackass's headquarters is. We all know. Where is it?
Go up to Satan Tofu's throne.
Isn't it?
Hope you're armed. Moving on.
I don't know. What happens if we take 200,000 light warriors and go, hey, I'm going to Satan Tofu's throne. I hope you guys are armed. Moving on. I don't know.
What's 11 AI? He is dressed like a merman. That's very observant. Going over to Satan Tofu's throne. Hope you're armed. Moving on.
Days are coming. I'm just trying to say, can someone go for the head
Why
of the snake?
Why the fuck would you buy silver when you can buy 100 times
more bismuth? Why the fuck
would you buy silver when you could buy 100 times more bismuth?
I don't know. These days are coming. I'm just trying to say, can someone go for the head of the snake? I'm so
bored.
All of these.
I'm bored.
You know? Listen, my guides are telling me everything's chill.
Cheap as fuck AI shit. We could do it. We could look into it. That'd be fun. We could get, I mean, the thing is that I can't generate anything funnier than what Rion is doing. I think he's a singular voice.
In the sense of like, yo, they're going to run this program.
Yeah.
To get the maximum yield of people.
Yeah.
To wake up.
It's awesome. You probably had a great prom. Oh!
People out there that are very upset. And I get that. Okay, but I'm also trying to say.
Oh, I think Rion's beyond Q. He probably thinks that Q is a fucking hologram.
That the direction of the rage and all of this frustration should not be at the people exposing it. It should be at those responsible. Okay, I'll say that one more time. The frustration and rage of all the people waking up should not be directed at those that are exposing the truth.
Yeah. All right. Well, let's check out this AI thing. If you're so smart. 11 AI. I'm not seeing it. What is it? AI 11, 11, I don't see it. I'm not seeing it. I think you made it up. No, I'm kidding. Voice generator. text-to-speech voice cloning.
As an organizer, I start from where the world is as it is, not as I would like it to be.
Okay. And then you can tell it who to be.
And words, man! We made them up!
Is that a thing? You tell it who to be? Is that what it is?
The ball sex revolution is here.
is that fun?
The ball sex revolution is here.
Okay. Okay, two or three. Okay, that's fun. Wow, text-to-speech has gotten really good.
What's up, assholes? I'm Big Fucker Troy Casey, certified health nut. Introducing the Baldo trademark, the world's first ball dildo. A new era in sex has arrived. Oh, we've created the world's first sex toy that will allow you to penetrate your partner with your balls and unleash pleasure that you've never experienced before. Let the ball sex revolution begin. Ever had a ballgasm? It's about to blow your ass mind.
That's fun.
Oh, fuck off.
You want to have the sliders down? Okay.
The ball sex revolution is here. Get a Baldo, dickhead. It'll blow your ass mind.
I mean, it's pretty good. It's pretty good. I like this, maybe.
Light it now. I'm dying here. Light it now. I'm dying here.
That's one of my favorite drops that we have. Yeah, how much does it cost? Okay. Free or $5 a month. Okay, cool. Okay, it's $5 a month for the voice cloning. Yeah, we could do it. Let's do it. I got nothing else going on. You pay for it? You already have it? You fuck. That's great. I don't know what I would do, but the accuracy, I want to hear the moaning. Really, I just want to hear the moaning that Jordan Teepee has been talking about. I also have more videos to watch if you'd like that. If you like that, we got some spec. You remember spec?
Signs of black magic. How do I know if someone did black magic on me? As we all.
You won't know if somebody did any black magic on you.
Signs of black magic.
We could do Spectre Ball. Thank you for subscribing to Hold Space for My Tribe. Thank you for subscribing. The ball sex revolution. Oh. Oh. Spec has been chronically online, and his content is not all fantastic. I also hope he continues to have that standing breakfast date. That sounds great. I worry that Spec's a little lonely sometimes. Maybe he could hang out with this guy.
Our greeting to the human race. We are the Puritav Illumu, and we came from the star system Muvail.
Did you catch that? We are the Puritav Illumu.
We are average-sized amphibian humanoids with gray skin, elongated skull, and long pointed ears. We are peaceful and discreet, and work as watchers for the Galactic Federation of Worlds.
We are peaceful and discreet.
Our activities are mainly about the monitoring of your oceans and ultimately the access and use of the interdimensional portals on Earth. We have very large discoidal ships you USO, unidentified submerged object.
Oh yeah.
We have three huge bases on Earth in vast suboceanic.
I like how he calls his own bases huge. Fuckable without even looking.
North Atlantic, Baltic Sea, and North.
Alright, Krosif, we'll watch your rap.
Our race was mostly seen around the Oregon area and the American Northwest.
Yeah, they're mostly seen in Oregon.
In the 1980s and the 1990s, we...
In the 1980s and the 1990s...
...crashes with U.S. Navy ships while the Americans were testing the new sonar and radar systems.
I love it. What's up, assholes? Troy Casey here. Big fucker Troy Casey here. Oh, I love it.
It's not working.
Starseed rap, hell yeah. Give me that starseed rap, okay. Give me your starseed rap today. You say this is kind of a tough one. Let's try it. Try me. Lemon grab. I definitely want to sit on Purite's head. Illumu. Puritav Illumu. This is cool.
They've been doubting since the joke said, Frank, you wasting all your time and shit.
He's watching in the lowest quality possible.
He had their life for something happens.
He's watching in 144p.
And then someone fucking notices something that they shared but didn't make them fucking over it. Go ahead and smoke some weed. Go ahead and do some pills. Go ahead and get your job. Go ahead and pay the bills.
We'll watch it in high quality.
That ain't me. That ain't me. That ain't me. Call me something crazy for it. That shit is so crazy boring.
Yeah.
I don't belong here. I ain't from around here. I wanna die here. I am not a human. I was just made here. I just stay here. It ain't so easy to tell. Why did I go through?
I wonder if you can see this. There's, you know, they've composited in this big moon so close, but you can, you know, it's a little line there where it's cut off, where the luma keying is not so great. Or not, maybe they didn't luma key, they probably color keyed, but the mask is a little rough around the tree line. I'd send this one back if I had paid for it.
Yeah, I just stay here. It's so easy to tell. Why did I go through hell? And why did I stick around when ain't nobody been down? And what the fuck have you done? Why ain't you number one? Where the fuck?
Hey, but the tracking's not bad. I'll give him that. The tracking's not bad. When the camera pans, the tracking is not bad.
I got a funds and you did all the drugs. I thought you said you were buying a Lambo. You should be leaving for Dubai. Baby, just go.
Yeah.
Up in the sky staring at all the stars.
All right, that kind of looks like shit too.
That is where I'm from, feel it in my heart. Yeah, look up in the sky, stare at all the stars.
Tracking's not bad.
That is where I'm from, I feel it in my heart. There's a reason you ain't got the new number, little bitch. I'm on the track to get rich. And I know how friends are turning snakes when they jealous. I ain't got time for that shit. I got people who love me, they coming with me. Range Rovers.
All right, don't bore us, get to the chorus.
Me, so I'ma hop this puddle like it's nothing to me. Two Lamborghinis up in the UK. I'm on the wrong side like a one-way.
Talks about
just had to come.
Lamborghinis a lot.
Such a good day is a forte.
Hey, yo.
Say good day, good day, good day. Like ole, ole, ole. Hop a red eye straight to Spain just to blow this guacamole. Like, look up in the sky, stare at all the stars. That is where I'm from, feel it in my heart.
I like how they left in a shot of him pulling up his pants.
All the stars. Yeah, that is where I'm from, I feel it in my heart. They've been doubting since the jump said, Frank, you wasting all your time and shit. But they ain't dedicated, have their life for something happens big. They on their fucking phone hoping that someone fucking notices something that they shared but didn't make them fucking over it. Go ahead and smoke some weed. Go ahead and do some pills. Go ahead and hate your job. Go ahead and pay the bills. That ain't me. That ain't me. That ain't me. Where the fuck is something crazy for it? That shit is so crazy boring.
That you say you were buying a lamp.
Yeah. All right.
Bye, baby, just go.
He's going to be disappointed with the guacamole in Spain. I like that as the takeaway. Like, ooh, he's really not going to like the guacamole in Spain. I don't think he will. I don't think he knows what he's getting himself into there. Let's see our old friend the vape do some stuff, huh? I like how he starts the video with this sound.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah.
That's nice. I want more of that, actually. Could I have another helping? Could I have another helping of that, please, Peter?
Yeah.
Thank you. Thank you, Peter. All right, what have you got for us today?
Yeah, so,
yeah. Right, to be very extremely materialistic while insisting that you're not of this plane.
So, Vince, my brobla sovidi. Gens Firborin Firborin Garapolo Soto.
Hola, Tiger.
Thank you.
Hola.
I'm tired here. Light it.
Light it.
I've been doing this in my personal life way too much.
Light it.
What was I even gonna say? I got totally sidetracked. Oh yeah, this video to me isn't so much about his contraption, but more about the struggles of wearing glasses and over-ear headphones. It can be a little bit difficult. Touch it again. Touch it again!
Don't see me be singing, doy.
Oh, yeah. I spark my own J-bone. I'm an adult. I'm grown. This guy's awesome. So he does this for a good 5 minutes. I like the end of the video, though, when he talks about it more.
Sir. Yo, guys, Mario. Guys.
Yeah, Christ. Long pause. And I get to watch him sort of disengage, you know? Yep. Love you, Mr. Valak. Much bless. It's funny. He's good. Boo bay bay boo 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 bay 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 boo. I like, yeah, Simon the Magpie does cool shit too. He's pretty fun to watch. Okay. Riz Mirza. Psychic Riz the Wiz. They call him the Wiz because he's good at so many things. Stumbled across a video of him channeling someone other than Red Eagle. If you don't remember Red Eagle, this is him doing Red Eagle.
We come to say the final words to you.
Here we go.
Hello. I'm Red Eagle. We come to say the final words to you. If you do not.
Yeah, that's him.
And the magic of life is not only in the pleasant experiences, there's magic happening everywhere at all times. This device that you are watching this transmission on is made of countless particles that are pulsating and radiating. In fact, your phone, your laptop, all of it is breathing.
Your laptop.
To take the sacred plant medicine to see it. The tree is breathing. Everything is breathing. This computer that you are on is not even a solid. There are many, many, many small particles pushed together, but there is space in between them.
Yeah.
All of these particles are pulsating, radiating, moving. They have a frequency.
So I thought that he could only do one bad accent, but he can do more.
And that's what that clearing is, to allow that flow of water, the English Channel, the Suez Canal. Those are all the same meanings. But in esoteric thinking, in shamanic and psychic teaching, we say the body is the same way. We are the channel.
So that's his normal voice. He channels a clock master named Phineas Quimby in this video.
And with your palms facing upward, please. Thank you. And those in the back, just relax and close your eyes. As you close your eyes, I want you to begin by relaxing, just dropping your...
This is from the Conscious Life Expo earlier this year.
No. You are exactly where you are supposed to be right now, with who you are supposed to be with. We're going to start off with just a cleansing breath. That breath we're going to take in through our nose.
Cleanse me.
And we'll just send the air down into your belly. Let's just keep it simple and hold the breath till...
Send it down into my belly button.
You're just going to release any stagnation, tension, or resistance in yourself.
Yeah. Don't mind if I do.
Do it twice. Ready? One, two, breathe in.
Quimby steam fuck.
Please. Relax your chest, relax your face, and blow it out.
Oh, blow it out.
Time half the speed, please. Slower, breathe in. Even slower.
His hair is, yeah, he's got a lot going on.
And hold the breath. Relaxing.
Looks complex.
Even more, relaxing your chest, no tension in the body, and gently exhale, bowing your head forward. As you bow your head forward, I ask you to connect to your source. I ask you to see the source as light that is emanating from the space between your eyebrows.
Stinky. He's leading everybody in like a group meditation before he channels Phineas Quimby.
To gently.
The clock master.
Powerfully expand. Like ripples in a pond. These waves of light are expanding in each and every direction around you, above you, behind you, top to bottom, side to side. Now this light is around you, 2 to 3 feet around.
Good job, Kenneth.
My friends, this light is not actually meant to protect you.
He is, his head does kind of look like an egg with asparagus coming off of it.
Hold it there as I say this blessing, thank you. Continue to relax.
Let's hear him bless.
Great spirit of love, thank you for uniting us this beautiful day. Thank you for the many blessings of the past, the present, and the future.
Yeah.
And thank you for the many blessings in disguise of the past, present,
and the future. Oh, yeah, no, I like that. Oh.
And nourish our bodies, our minds, our spirits. Help us to help others do the same. Help
I'm sure you could find a cock master online somewhere.
And have her guide us and
assist us.
We send love to our ancestors.
Both. All right, I want to see him become Phineas, but I don't know how hard that's going to be to find because his blessing is so fucking long. Here we go.
There is no separation between anything. And if there is something that you refer to as anything, even that is a part of you. You heard this from your gurus and your saints and your own understanding and receiving of information, for you yourself are a psychic being. Your senses are far more than five, far more than six.
Yeah.
Perhaps there are hundreds, thousands of
DJ Khaled is the opposite of Gilgamesh.
You have a sense of peace, a sense of balance, a sense of justice.
Yeah.
The sense of love.
Of course.
And these senses.
That's true.
Continually being processed by this interface called the human body.
I think he quimbs out for like an hour. Let's see what got a laugh.
You are told to have dreams, but don't be a dreamer. If what they were to tell you, the world is a safe place. A person could sit upon this stage and tell you, the world is a safe place. Now everyone respond with your organic response. And many will say, no, here's a list of why it is not a safe place. Let me first tell you what has happened to me and my brother and my father and my sister and my people.
Oh, okay.
And then what has happened to those people and those people and that civilization. And what will happen if I walk down this neighborhood? The world is not a safe place.
I always felt that there was a crystal skull buried under the sea.
You are talking about the master skull.
But are you safe? Well.
I want to see him come out of it.
very much in her feminine body, but very young. So when the planet is gone, and all of you are gone, and there is nothing in this space where the Earth used to be, do you think there will be no more dolphins? They will be swimming in the cosmic consciousness the way they always have been. The way you have always been. And your focus, when you step out of the dream state, when you come back to Earth, suddenly you say, ah, this is real life, and that was a dream.
Yeah, his eyes are completely open now.
Ah, is this real life?
Do this at a high school.
She is still her, and the hotel is still the hotel, and in the mirror I'm still me. Well then, that is not a very good proof or evidence or validation that this is real and not, because if we were to ask you that in the dream state, you would say the same thing. If we were to enter into your dream tonight, you're having a dream, we enter and say, is this real? And you would say, well, of course it is. I'm very angry with this person, I'm trying to have this discussion here. That happens in your dreams.
Oh, yeah.
And so, something has to happen, because at the very core of what...
Okay, I want to hear him come out of the fucking Quimby state.
And that the kangaroo giving birth that you are showing him on your YouTube is not inside this piece of iron and glass. And he was one of the most intelligent men in the history.
Yeah, he is killing. He's talking about. It's cool to hear him say YouTube.
Time.
Yeah.
Speaking of time, dear, we have some more singing.
No.
So we must draw to a close.
Yeah.
Let us take one more. But be sure it's a good one. Right here in front of the channel, you there. Yes.
Come out of it, Riz.
Love. You are magic itself, because it is all a mystery. And magic and science are the same thing. They are the discovery of what exists and how to work with it.
YouTube.
In your alchemy. Share with one another. Take time and pause and take information in. And we are with you. Bless you.
Thank you, Phineas Quimby. Never made it as was me. Never made it as a Quimby, Phineas.
Thank you, guys. Boy, I hate to say, but there were other guys waiting, but Phineas went like this. He was sort of like, I got this. Thank you so much for being here. And thank you.
Nice, man. Phineas fucking stole the stage. Fucking Phineas, dude. Couldn't say no to Phineas, dude. Shit, man. Where can we see Riz?
By the way, I just want to say something. Speaking of which, and I wanted to talk about this. You know, I lead retreats. My wife and I read retreats all over the world. We have our company is called Sacred Earth Retreats, and you guys, I'm sure you'll put my website. You guys, come
sure, 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 yeah, yeah.
We just came back from Egypt. I take people to mystical trips into the pyramids. I channel on.
What's your gamble?
And around the pyramids with our camels, I sit there on the sand and we get messages. And we go to Japan. We're going to Japan.
Light it.
Spring. We have an Egypt retreat coming up.
Look at that.
And we have a Mount Shasta.
Look at that. He's going to Shasta. He's going to fucking Shasta. But you know what? I think this one's going to get rescheduled. He's trying to go to Mount Shasta March 8th. Good luck to you, pal. Good luck. I-5 will fucking not be open, dude. I tell you what.
The retreat coming up. Sedona, Arizona.
Good luck to you.
Or Texas on the land. And a really special one I just added, which is a paranormal retreat, which is happening in Salem, Massachusetts.
Yeah.
In October. staying at a beautiful, beautiful haunted historic site.
All yeah, man, go to Salem.
To see, and we go into Salem every day, and we're doing channeling and ghost hunts. And
they're gonna go. That's the house where they're staying at. Isn't that cool? That's a fucking wild place to stay. I can't believe that they had a vacancy. You know, I think he has a stepdaughter, right?
Going into the forest with the local witches there. So if you're interested in that, please go to my website, rizmirza.com, and you'll see.
Cool picture of Riz there.
Information. And I do phone sessions, by the way, guys.
How do you define God?
Love. Because when I experience love, I'm experiencing God. Of course I am.
Nice. The Science of Manifestation by Phineas, channeled by Riz Mirza. Yeah, man. Every man on the stream is addled by syphilis. It's true. It's true. Out of body experience to Shasta. Yeah. That was Giardia. Yeah. He's not going to have a good time in Shasta. I tell you that much. That's a bad time to go. Kind of like Nancy Pelosi.
So I have plenty of videos at this point talking about how early August is atrocious. Videos here on YouTube. We've talked about it. But I looked at Nancy Pelosi's chart, and I didn't think I was going to see anything. I was like, there's no way that this Taiwan shit's going to be that intense. I hate that I did look at it, and like it does look like...
What a hard voice to listen to.
Yeah, that's how I would describe it as well.
Bohab James!
Uranus North Node conjunction, all at 18 degrees of Taurus, is atrocious, has not happened anywhere like this since, I mean, Alexander the Great times. And in lovely Nancy's chart here, this is happening on her Uranus within 1 degree. Her midheaven within about 6 degrees, which represents public image or career, and her Venus, her Mars, all very close. It's yeah. One thing to have Uranus just kind of hanging out there, but with the North Node and Mars crossing it exactly by degree, this.
Let me grab Bohab's video here. What do you got? Whoa, this looks cool. I don't know. I've never seen it, but this looks cool. Let's watch it. F6 Plus held over 40 seconds in a dirty shirt.
Get a little higher. Low.
Her Enos.
Get a little lower.
Nancy Pelosi is 1 degree away from my Enos. Let's fucking let this rip. In a dirty shirt, no less. This is awesome. Hey, that's too loud. Don't do that. This is what YouTube was made for. Wow, 40 seconds. I'll never fix my volumes. That was awesome.
Oh, fuck off.
That guy does cool stuff.
Working on transition, trying to have less skipping as I go into the lower fifth octave in my voice. And try and show that. Coming up.
This is fucking cracking me up.
I'm hoping to do a video today. Asking people to make.
He's got a lot of videos. Highest note sung by man, my attempt. Me after putting a rubber glove full of kratom up my ass.
Light it!
What else is it? We got a C1? Let's try C1. Whoa. Oh, can you hear that?
Light it now! I'm talking to you! Light it!
This is awesome, Bohab. I love this guy. He's got some stuff talking about the Bible. Low breathy anti-anxiety protest ASMR. The B-movie magazine time puzzle. Now, I have to watch that. B-movie danger codes. So this guy's into B-movie stuff? Communal video as a disease of being in the B-movie. The Halo theme bathroom meme movie. The B-movie smoking pun. There's a lot of B-movie content here. Wow. More notes being sung. Why is Moana like Lord of the Rings? What a guy. Thank you for me and the Beddington Duck 60,000. Oh, wow. I love this. I certainly do love this. I want more singing. Why? All right, I'm sorry. I have a lot here.
The B-movie uses various techniques that are a little analogous to hypnotism. One of these is confusion, presenting things that don't make any apparent sense, but which can't be analyzed easily at a conscious level.
Yeah.
And since the B-movie, by its very nature, is not supposed to be a very good movie, it doesn't attract a lot of critical attention and analysis, which makes it, in a good way, an effective tool for influencing people.
What?
In a bad way, as I would see, as to the results obtained from that influence. The technique employed at one point has to do with the confusion generated by time distortions. I've discussed space distortions in an earlier video.
Wow, he's really... Wow. Really got a thing about the B-movie.
I've been able to hold some of my C6s longer lately, so I haven't sung anything yet today. I'm going to see if I can have any success with it.
This is awesome. I could watch this all goddamn day.
Time I try and film this video, the duck moves in a little bit closer. I think it must be a little bit of a publicity hound. And
must be a publicity hound.
Celebrate my latest 10,000 subscriber milestone for the channel. Thank you everybody so much for all of your support in helping me get this far.
Yeah. I
thought I'd have a shot at 100,000, and it seems like that's starting to look a little bit more possible now. This is a lovely little spot, sometimes labeled as Beddington Creek on maps, but That's not, I'm not quite sure about it because there's a larger creek to the south and west that's occasionally binned.
What is this guy's deal? He's some, okay, he's Canadian. Joined in 2012. Pay attention to the details. Did you know it's gotta be? Pay attention to the details.
Don't you know it's gotta be me? Since my last video filmed in this little quilt space, I've found that many more references have come up on the topics that I raised. So I'm trying to do a little bit of an update here, largely with similarities between topics discussed in alternative media and some extent mainstream media.
Yeah. And
attributes of the god in the Disney movie Hercules. The god being the god of the underworld, Hades. His symbolism and attributes correspond to a lot of the topics raised, such as the Punisher. That is a skull logo brought up pretty recently and frequently. And that is also worn on one of the straps of Hades' outfit. Yeah, he has a skull worn in the same.
What is going on?
He is also the one who oversees the punishment of those who come into Hades when they die. He has two servants called Pain and Panic. And Pain and Panic are words that have been quoted very often recently with regard to magicians who...
Well, he talks about some cool stuff.
Which has been mentioned quite frequently since my last reference.
Puns!
Or less place.
Talk to me about puns!
Rapidly drains away the person most benefiting from the draining of the swamp, in a way, would be Hades himself. There's a lack of constructive effort in The Adventures of Hercules.
Alright, I like his singing videos. The other stuff's a fucking waste of time. Hey, I saw somebody wearing my shirt. It's the lady with the annoying voice.
Amazing news is that Mercury retrograde is now over. So after 3 weeks of inconveniences in travel, communication, and logical thinking, those things will be easier moving forward. This is especially relevant for Geminis, Virgos, and Tauruses who would have been hit by this hardest. I can attest to this.
Yeah.
And it's not exactly like today. It's easier automatically. But as we move forward, you will find more ease and things getting resolved that may have been troublesome over the past 3 weeks. Amazing news is that...
How'd she get my shirt? Guess what? She makes music. Let's check it out. She makes music. Convince, confuse, transform, transfuse. Let me receive all the abuse for you. It's pretty dark. Pretty gross. I budge though. This is weird and gross. It would have been, yeah, this would have done a lot better about 15 years ago. It's, yeah, it's a lot like Evanescence. This is Maren Altman. It's called Autographs in Hell. This was produced by Axiom 8, edited by Dan Doby. The Black Hat VFX. Key grip was Mike Long, you know? Yeah, it's a long fucking song, too, man. Wow. As always, glad to be a part of this marinara sauce. You know? That's cool. This is actually fucking so good and memorable and not cringe at all. Yeah, man. Fucking shit, dude. You listen to Dust Machine? like the fan in my room or what? I have not listened to Dust Machine. I'm not doing a Patreon stream today. We're just gonna keep on rocking in the free world today because I gotta get out of here a little bit.
Refrigerators.
A little bit earlier than normal. Not that much earlier, but a little bit earlier. I got like another half hour with you. So if you do have something to watch, go ahead and send it through. I got more, but just because we're fucking hanging out, you know, I'll loosen up. I'll loosen my grip a little bit.
God entered into my body like a body my same size, like me floating into you, you floating into me. It's June the 15th, 2023. It's Thursday. And I see nonstop visions from God. And let God talk.
Yeah.
Tell him that I heard a word of the Lord. You are going to go to the gas station. Showed him what I showed you. He showed me filling up my mug.
Yeah.
Go and do it right now.
Go and do it right now.
That's all Jesus shows up the lip. Let's fill it up with diet drink. I don't really want to. I'm not expecting anything to happen if I do. But let's see.
Just Jesus told me to fill up my mug with diet drink. I don't really want to, but let's see what's going on. Dust Machine. You want my ass to watch Dust Machine. And is this just a machine that produces dust? Let's find out. Let's find out. Hey, man, glad to be here. You send me something? Okay. I'll check the Discord. All right, so far, not interested. This is pretty sick. Yeah, I can do that.
God entered into my body, like a body my same size, like me floating into me, floating into me. It's June 15th, 2023. It's Thursday. And I see nonstop visions from God. And let God talk.
Alright, I'm bailing on Dust Machine, sorry. Sorry, didn't do it for me. You did good with the other submission though, and I appreciate you and thank you. But I don't know what you were going for there. Somebody put something in submissions. Next time, just try to make me groan. How to wax your cheese. Now, Jamer, this better be good. Okay? This better be good. And I'm giving it a little preview. Make sure you're not trying to pull one on me. It's just, it looks like just someone waxing cheese.
Before you wax your cheese, that your temperature of your wax is only at about 80.
All right, I do like this.
Celsius. That's all we need. And just make sure that when you're dipping your wax, your cheese into your wax.
I like the voiceover a lot, Jamer. A
couple of coats, at least two. I prefer three. And where you can't get coverage and there's bubbles or something like that, then just use a brush. I've got cheese making brushes.
Sorry. I like this a lot. Wex.
Bristle brush.
My bristle brush for my wex.
Cheese with wax from that little brush.
Three coats of wex. Let's watch that again.
Just remember, here's a few pointers for when you wax your cheese. Make sure you melt it using steam.
Melt.
The wax melting bowl, the one I just unboxed, on top of a pot. And as you can see, there's some water in there, some steam coming out. So the steam is melting it. So make sure that you, before you wax your cheese, that your temperature of your wax is only at about 80 to 90 degrees Celsius. That's all we need.
That's all we need.
When you're dipping your wax, your cheese into your wax, that you manage to get a couple of coats, at least two.
Jamer, I gotta say, this is fucking great.
Region, there's bubbles or
thank you, Jamer.
Then just use a brush. I've got cheese making brushes. Sorry, cheese wax brush.
Jamer, goddammit, you hit this one out of the park.
Coat the cheese with...
You get me and my taste exactly, Jamer. That was good. 10 out of 10. God damn. Really good job. Good stuff. What else did I want to show you? We've got a... I love pants! There's this Skylife video about this, like, Cleopatra shit. Have you seen this? Do you know about this? It's not great. Gil Givens distilling his piss. That was a hit. Let's watch another video of someone drinking piss.
Don't, you'd be fine.
This is called Joshua Drinks His Urine. It's from 16 years ago. And it sure looks like it.
Don't, you'd be fine. On the count of three, take one sip of your very own urine, and then we want you to hold it in your mouth for a few seconds and swallow. One, two, three.
Oh.
Don't gag. Have you swallowed?
Yeah, it's gone.
Did he do it?
I don't think he did.
Oh, behave, you know.
Did you do it,
honestly? Oh,
behave. Where I did it.
All right, okay, well, do how did it taste?
Not as bad as I thought it was going to be.
Really? What did it taste of?
Well, it's cold and it's a bit sweet. It doesn't taste like anything you buy, obviously, but yeah, it tastes a bit sweet. It's still pretty sickly, but...
Do me a favour then, okay? Whilst drinking your own urine, bear in mind you think it doesn't taste too bad, take one more sip.
This is so weird.
Oh, go on, Josh.
Gargle it around like mouthwash.
I don't want to see that. That's too much. I don't want to see Joshua gargle his own piss. No, thank you. I'm weird. I'm fucked up, but I don't... Jimmy! I like how you've designated your own one as nice. That's fun. You gave me a nice one in submissions, huh? Arcturian Council? Yeah, fuck yeah. You know what I like. You know what I'm into. Let's do it. Give me a nice one. Give me a
nice one.
Here we go. That was kind of a fetish video. I didn't mean to expose you to that. But I don't regret it either.
This is how this begins.
Excuse me?
It's raw, 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 raw.
Your own urine. Will Joshua retch from the gargle? Oh, I don't want to waste your gamble on that.
Turn it off and on, we demand to the classic. It's drastic for the bite of the pain. Basic acid, plastic, monocle, racist, destruction, and scanning. You could find a script, but it's not loving, scanning. Feed it for the dream, level limits with the mocap. I'ma save my soul, set it straight, make a format, torment. The support of the fiend, cruiser, torment, of what we'll analyze, a wiser wizard, all. Consider me annihilated, label me dead.
Wow, this is wild.
No, it's doing. I'm the creator with the lyrical styles, missing out on it like that. Plus I'm hidden in the vine, like peppermint red lights, hard to find and divine with lyrical styles, and I stay right in the vine. It is like the light, and it's infinite and divine. It is oscillating in the frequency that sees one of them. You can't get with me, one another course. But the wolf is lyrical style, but the ferocious flows are over those bones, are ripping up your shoulders. You couldn't even say,
we'll gamble on something else.
Rip or handle the scenario. Yes, style is precarious, fabulous, coming from the underground like cabbage. God can't contain this. With your premature ejaculative mind, you're still locking on minus.
Ejaculative mind?
On a blanket like Linus, doing this in a slow mo. So a slow pro couldn't even understand the flow. So bringing it back, you claiming to be the master of a vast blast, entertainment masses, massive passages. The gates might open gates, the fountain of stars, I'm just moving up, smacking the king.
This is wild.
I'm all vacant to like me, a brain chemical reaction, fascinating, reanimating, retro box, create, I know you're hitting stars, and you can't put people in damage, because on the microphone, and I'm getting paid. Twisting it, ripping scripts, busy kid, quick and nigga, yo, is picking it on the skull of the lips. They ain't saying shit. They think it's undersized, of course. Oh my god, they ain't saying shit. Now what to do when the whole rap style is through? Once again, readjust your ears and camera.
Yeah.
I'm Arcturus Raw.
He does kind of have the Rion flow.
Figaro.
Figaro. and I can stupefy. Yeah. That he did that at the end. That was fun. The pest intro. What is the pest intro? You gotta help me out.
Truth tellers, right? Should never be directed at us. Why? We didn't do it. We just told you about it. Don't shoot the messenger.
Yeah.
So mixed on this planet. They want everyone to be so swayed left and right. You're this, you're that. Bruh.
Oh, from the movie The Pest?
Gives you access.
You want to watch the beginning of the movie The Pest? So do I. Is he, he's like farting in the shower or something? Let's watch it. Let's watch it, dude. I'm ready.
Do my piece, cruising creep, playing three car money on these crazy streets. Straight hustler, I'm all a scam and I'm in it. So low to the flow, pick the pocket, I'm a midget. Slick shyster, the best meister, living life in Miami's vice. Mash, see? Nobody messing with the frog, see? Watch him a slam now. Like a booger, I stick to this. Take a whiff of this.
I'm stinky dinky, stinky dinky,
Yeah. I think he did say stinky dinky.
Who is the slickest of them all?
It's the scheminess, keenest scam artist.
God, it's so hard to be modest.
Jack my minimal, but I'm a sex symbol. So slick, I stole a wig from his candlestick.
I'm in the mood to scam, simply because I can.
I'm a Latin Houdini.
Disappear in a flash with your cash in a bank like a genie.
Lucy, I'm home, dando la torrella say.
Brick to the east, brick to the west.
What's this guy doing now?
Yes, y'all, and it's like that.
Why slightly? No.
Get stupid, get retarded, cause plans to get the party started. Which way did it go, George? Which way did it go? Fugalocious, fugalocious atrocious.
Ah, this is a lot. Shamer, you here?
I'm a man of a million disguises. I'm this crazy, I can make them, I shake them, I like them, so scientific.
Whoa. What's that movie about? I don't remember. This movie was adored in my childhood, but I can't remember. He was in The Menu. Ah, yes, The Menu. Yeah, definitely. He's just a pest. Okay. Well, he's just obnoxious. Sure. Yeah, and he pesters. He's a pestering pest. I understand. I understand that. I'm a lightmare myself.
The secret they don't want you to know. Okay? And I told you this long time ago, when you're hacking beings, listen, when you grab a being that's being a jackass, don't just black bag special it. Grab it. That's what I do. I grab it and I go, hey, little guy, where are you from? You know what I mean? I do the like, where's your daddy? And what you do is you go ahead and track that cable.
Yeah.
Back to whatever it's projecting from.
Track that cable.
And it's Pac-Man, bro. Manja, 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 manja. Oh, you're the one who gave this little thing orders. Let's talk for a hot second. What are you doing here? Do you have the right to be here? Are you a refugee?
I love this.
What is your motivation for being on the surface of this world, and who are you interacting with? What I get to is there are different levels of interrogation. What I'm trying to express to you, which I've said many times, especially when I grabbed these little jagaloons 3 weeks ago. Okay?
Jagaloons.
If things are just following orders, who gave you the order? What's the name? Where are they right now?
Yeah.
Okay. We're not. I'm just trying to be real with you guys. And happy Father's Day. But as you guys are waking up into how big of a seraphim you really are, as you're laying on your back here in this pool, you know, you start sitting up and going, yeah, I think I'm done being messed with. Can I just have, you know, I don't know what it is. I can't explain to you.
What happened to that Enki guy? Yeah. Wow, I've kind of forgot about that. That was a while ago. This cleanses me as well. I don't know. I like being along for the ride. There's always something really fucking dumb right around the corner, you know? Makes me happy.
Another cool thing. Oh, dope dream. I saw what happened with Mr. T. And I was in the room and...
Donald Trump?
He was in a higher dimension. This whole thing was going on upstairs as it was downstairs. And I can tell you that not only is he going to win that this whole indictment thing, but there was something else about it where since the upper dimensions have already been cleared and cleaned and organized in a specific way, that it will cascade down to the physical. We're just waiting for that to play out. Okay. That's all I'd like to say about it. Okay. I had a dream about it. Hurrah.
He has dreams about Donald Trump's indictment. What's going on?
Oh yeah. Yeah. Let the fear just purge out of you.
Here we go.
That's why we go through so much weird shenanigans down here, because those shenanigans kept our family unconscious and asleep. We're the strong ones.
Here we go.
First to say, hey, I don't believe any of this shit. You're coming with me. We're out, you know? You're throwing your mom and your dad over your shoulders. And you're like, yeah. Oh, yeah. Mom, listen to MSNBC. That's a great idea. I'm just hot tossing through Golden Gates. I'm like, boom. Okay, I'm going to go back down and get Grandma, Grampy, and my ex-girlfriend and my best friend. I'll be right back. Oh, yeah. Let the fear just purge out of you while I'm carrying you. Here we go. Yeah. Here. Hello. Right back. I got to go grab some more of my homies.
Nice.
I don't know.
I love that your dad is a fan.
Like Wreck-It Ralph. I'll just keep running up and down those stairs until we all get out of here.
I'm like Wreck-It Ralph.
Just like me. Don't forget that. Happy Father's Day. And the card for the Lyrans is planetary
cars cycle, of
cycles, completion, moving forward. We all know this is the end of the Kali Yuga, ladies and gentlemen.
Get it's not.
For what?
The Sabra is the hummus of the Kali Yuga. We all know this, and it's just beginning.
Play race is just something that needs to be made and talked about. You got Raphael, you got Uriel, you got Gabriel, you got Mikael. You're like, look, bro, how many did you get? It's a timed event. We got 6 hours. Whoever saves the maximum amount of souls on the list wins. You know? I mean, why do we have all these lame games down here? How many souls can you save in 6 hours? Action! You know?
He loves that voice.
Literally, this song in the background is I Need a Hero.
Whippy crack.
Volume on that.
He's fun. I don't know why I think he's from this prison. So captivating. I just do. He goes off the rails.
Inner constitution of that I am a being of grace and divinity and
power. He believes such wild stuff, and he talks about it so confidently. It's just fun. It's just fun to be along for the ride, sit on his shoulders, let him carry you through golden gates, you know? I want him to carry me. I just want him to carry me, that's all. There are so many types of guy in this world. Any new? Oh, yeah, the Peter Dislike Show is one of the most active channels I've ever seen. We can check in with him. Peter Dislike Show. A new favorite spot. No, that's old. That's from a month ago. Yeah, I don't know. He's got some bismuth stuff. I don't know what he's into lately. We haven't reached his big, billionaire Bismuth Scheme Day.
Bum, bum,
yeah.
Bum, 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 bum,
bum, bum, bum, bum.
The Peter Dislike Show.
Why the fuck
bum, bum,
would
bum,
you
bum,
buy
bum, 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 bum,
when you can buy a
so
hundred more bismuth?
Yeah. Why the fuck
would you
buy silver
when you can buy 100 times more bismuth?
Week, I acquired some tin bars, just 100% tin. Now,
whoa.
The problem with pouring pure tin is that tin has a tendency to disintegrate over a long period of time. If it ever goes below, I think 60 degrees Fahrenheit, right? Not crazy temperatures, right? But over the long period of temperatures below that, tin will change into its non-metallic form. Tin is in the same family as carbon, and so it will change its structure into a hard, brittle, non-metallic tin. Basically,
yeah.
Kind of like diamond, but with tin atoms instead of carbon, which is very hard and brittle, and also a much lower density than metal, so it will squeeze.
My other crypto is bismuth.
Once that process gets started, it completely disintegrates.
Okay.
In fact, actually, 90% tin and...
He's talking about tin.
...amounts, it's even worse. Like a 10-carat tin, right? Although, it'd be really
holy shit. He's talking about tin for a long time. This is what precious metals can teach us about pride.
Bum, bum,
bum, bum, bum.
Oh. Bum, 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 bum,
bum, bum, bum.
So this whole year of 2023 has been marked for me by two things, right? My making art out of bismuth and now some other elements. And by the old dislike meme, right?
Dislike and, finger.
That is how I feel about my life in some regard. See, right now as I speak... Bismuth is one of the
got some long nails
elements on the periodic table relative to how rare it is, right? If you multiply the price by how much of each element there is, bismuth is like at the bottom of the list, right? I believe either gold or one of the rhodium, one of the precious metals at least, is near the top of the list, and by a huge margin as well, right? I think cap of gold is thousands and thousands of times bigger than that of bismuth for really no good reason other than that people are just crazy over it, right? And that's how I live my life, right? I'm a bismuth in a world full of gold, right?
I'm a bismuth in a world full of gold.
Despite the utility that I might bring to the table, people overlook me just because of differences in
sexuality,
eating habits, among other things. I feel like a lump of bismuth in a world full of gold. I really do.
Whoa, because of your sexuality and your eating habits?
Right.
What does he eat?
Well, here's another metal that causes that has an analogy in our society that causes people to... not see what they need to see.
He loves metals.
Tin. It's actually
he eats ass, okay.
Tin and 2% bismuth because tin by itself is not very stable. Well, a lot of people have misconceptions about tin, right? I can't tell you how many times people tell me to wrap something in tin foil or their tin roof is leaking and they drink out of a tin can. Well, I got news for you. None of that is tin, at least anymore.
Holy shit.
Been at one time in
history. I got news for you.
At one time in history, aluminum was a precious metal. Novelties in the material.
Jeez, okay. He just talks about metals a lot. Listen, I gotta go. I gotta get the fuck out of here. Thank you for hanging out with me. I'm a prostate in a world of assholes. Something. I can't read what you're saying. He's blowing the lid off Big Tin. Thank you so much for hanging out with me here on Hold Space for My Tribe. We'll see you again soon. All the best. This was fun. Jammer, really, that cheese wax. 10 out of 10, bud. Big thank you. I gotta go boil my piss in an heirloom teapot. Mom's gonna be so mad. Mom's gonna be so mad. All right, I'll see you later. Bye.